this week on the Xtreme Crappie Angler.
Dude. Look at this, dude. I watched them eat it, dude.
Yeah, go on, yeah, right there.
We're addicted to crappie. It's sick, you know what I mean? It's like a disease. But you know what? It's not an addiction if you don't want to stop.
Right awesome. There, Carl.
Awesome.
This is huge. Hit like a bass.
Oh, he took wow. That's a big crappie, man.
Yeah. Oh, man. It doesn't get better than this.
I'm Karl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. The Xtreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, leader in crappie, Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor.
Don't even crank it down. Do a few cranks, let it come back up. We can do the same topwater thing you want. Watch. I do this with square bills for bass too. See that?
Yeah.
And then just let it come back up. If they're feeding up high like that.
Yeah, they are. Can you see them?
Yeah. I just missed one again. Right there. Oh, another one. See that?
Yeah, big swirl on it.
Look behind it. Oh my God, dude. Look, ready? Watch this. I saw him. There he is. Yep. Oh, another one. Did the back come up? And he missed it. Talk about aggressive crappie.
Oh, yeah. That one. Oh, did you see him swimming?
Yeah, man.
That's a nice one, dude.
Yeah. Look at this one.
Oh, holy boy.
God, dude. Watch out.
Oh. There you go, buddy.
Wow.
Man.
Catching them on a crank. Actually, it's almost like we're waking them.
Yeah.
First thing in the morning with the 3XD striking crappie crankbaits. Yeah, that's an eater, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. We'll put them in here. We're going to show you exactly what we're doing on a calm morning in early summer, throwing big crankbaits that you think for smallmouth or largemouth or even stripers and stuff. But for those, right there.
Right there.
Crappie. Is that a gill?
That a gill.
It just shows you, man, when you find the areas, provoke. In that morning bite, it's about 8:30 in the morning. And it's just a matter of casting out. And when the weeds come up, we're about 8-9 feet of water. And the weeds come up about 6 feet. So you got that level about 2 feet like this that those fish use. And they're just roaming. So we're looking around and fortunate because it's so calm, we can see the minnows busting, casting, letting it sit and twitch. And the crappie, just like anything else, they come up slow, or they just grab it slow and swim with it. So you have to keep your eyes peeled, but watch, because that first cast, they see it land like a bass. So just wait, and then just a slow roll, stop. Slow, stop. Well, it's coming up, it's usually two, and there they are. Let's go have some fun. Okay, I was throwing it on the Crappie Wizard, 7'6". I'd make those longer casts, didn't have to, but just a smooth and, you know, just the small twitches and stuff, but you have the length if you need to make longer casts and the sensitivity, but the soft tip, so when I leaned back, it didn't pull those treble hooks out of the crappie mouth. Yep. Oh my God, dude.
Oh, double header, Carl.
Yeah.
Double header on the 3X.
Look at this, man. I think I got a big gill.
I got a nice crappie, I think. Look at the splish splash.
Yeah, look at that.
Wow.
Big gill. Wow.
Here, let's see this. Look at that.
Cool.
Oh, yeah, man.
Oh, yeah. See that? Upsizing with the 3XD. Let me get my pliers here.
I'm just going to shake this guy off. And he took it and just started swimming with it sideways.
Bright, obnoxious colors. So look at chartreuse pink.
Yeah.
Pink chartreuse, tuxedo, and we're catching crappies. Basically, B&M, Crappie Wizard. I think that one's a Crappie Wizard too. Well, that's the new crappie spinning rod.
Yeah.
But making those shorter casts in front where you see the weed and not cranking it down, you know, just getting their attention and just cranking it, stopping it. But again, remember, when you make those first casts, the crappie take their time coming up. They look, and then... So just keep your eyes peeled on that first cast, waiting to see that bite. Let's get some more. Let it sit, come back up, twitch.
Yeah.
Wait for the big one to find it. You got him?
Oh, he nailed it. Doesn't take long.
No. You know, they know it's there. They're in attack mode right now.
Yeah, watch. You see him behind it? Look. Oh.
Wow, dude. Out of the water.
Dude, this is like smallmouth bass fishing.
It is. Look at the size of this crappie too, dude.
You got a tank. You want me to get the net?
Look at it. Dude, look at the size of this crappie.
Do you want me to get the net or are you going to swing them?
I'm swing them. Watch this.
Oh, man.
Hey. Is that exciting or what? Oh. Look where he's got it too. Look how close. You need those sharp hooks, man.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. How can you beat that, man? Hey, look at that. Beautiful fat slabs out here on the weed, eating the 3XD right on the surface. Twitch, twitch, boom! You see him come out of the water like this? Boom! Like a little whale back, eh? You a whale back? Yeah? Okay, we'll have you later. Thank you. Look at this, man. Simple, simple setup. I got all that stuff just floating on the surface because it's so calm. It doesn't even matter. But it's like pollen or whatever it is. But I tie right to the nose of the line tie, okay? And it's not about a lot of action here. It's just putting that bait where those fish are, making a little movement. And again, a little bit bigger bait, the 3XD, and we're finding those bigger crappies. Every time it comes up to the surface,
You
see some activity below it or beside it. Every time. And then all of a sudden, the big one's around. Whoa.
The big ones really hit it.
Yeah.
Or they just start swimming with it. Your line's going sideways.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, I got him.
Got him?
Came right up. Bang. They're hitting like bass.
Yeah.
Look at this. Look at the fight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
Can't beat it, man.
Bassing for slabs. That's all I got to say. Oh, man. Wow.
Oh, my God. When they come out of the water like that, it is sick.
Beauty.
Black like, back.
You can't beat that. You just can't.
Wow.
Oh, dude.
Did you see that?
You got a tank.
Yeah, man. I watched them come out of the water.
Dude, do you need a nut?
Look.
Buddy, that's a tank.
Oh my God, dude. Look at this thing.
Do you need the net, Carl?
I'll get him. I got a couple triple hooks.
Wow. This is not fair. Why are you catching all the big ones?
You want that one? Look at. You say to yourself, really? Look at that. Tell me he did not want that waked crank bait. Wow. I'm going to have to get him out of here. Let's see. Hey, what do you think, big boy? Nice little sharp red trebles. Ooh, that one's barely in. This one just right here. Go ahead and use pliers. And pliers just make it a lot more efficient. Not hurting me, not hurting the fish.
Carl, we're in another frenzy, buddy.
Right
it's
there.
All around us.
Look at that. That with that equals a lot of fun, man. You're never going to forget it if you pick up the 3XD, cast them with the crappie wizards, and find them on top, waking the crank for crappie. My God, is that ever fun? Phenomenal. Just beautiful eating-sized fish. Now, I know what you're thinking. Okay, they're catching this, you know, they're about the same size. You know what? This kind of fishing is like when you potentially can catch your biggest bass of the year on top. And we're not gonna say we're gonna do that, but I mean, when you see them how aggressive they are, it's these big ones are taking over. They're pushing out of the way of the smaller ones. So maybe we'll get one that we have to use the net. Now here's what the 3XD looks like as compared to the normal little striking Mr. Crappie crankbait. This is a traditional one with the bill too, dives down. We've caught him before with that little bait, but the 3XD with the bigger body, fatter profile, again with the bright obnoxious colors are the ones that those fish wanted to eat, waked and sat on the surface.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, wow.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh. Another tank?
Oh, buddy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, dude.
Dude, look at this.
I know. Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that.
This is amazing. This is like bassing for crappie.
Wow.
This is just.
That's a beautiful eater, too.
Oh, man. Tank. Look at the sharp hooks right in there.
Yeah, man.
Oh, beauty.
He's a boxer.
Oh, yeah.
And Sebastian's using the Bucks Graphite Crappie Spinning Rod, the 6.5. Again, you can make those casts, but we didn't really have to, you know, but we have the sensitivity and the butt section, a little bit of strength to make sure those trebles found the meat, but a sensitive tip not to pull the trebles out. And we're throwing both on the B&M Pro 100 spinning reel with 6-pound monofilament. Come on, crappies.
There you go. What
I think that's a big gill.
Is it? No, it's a big crappie.
I saw orange.
No.
You think that was my bait?
It's your bait, buddy.
Oh, boy.
Look at that tank.
Oh. Hey, the best of both worlds.
Oh, man.
Boy. Crappie on the crank, twitching on the surface. You talk about fun? Tell me that's not fun. Catching them like that on that little 3XD, they're not just for bass, man. They are for slabs as well. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Let's put them in a box and try to get some more. Whoa. You want to talk about having fun, man? Seriously, your best crappie holes, get out there, try the topwater action, man, or the little waking action like this. But we don't have to even wake these baits. We're just casting it, letting it settle, move a little bit, about a foot, comes back up, being patient, waiting for them to find it and eat it. Wow.
Oh!
Another beautiful fat crappie.
Wow. Wow. That's a nice one.
Oh, Carl. Yeah, man. Look. Oh, goodness me. Just gorgeous fish, boy. Gorgeous crappies, man. Catching them on the wake, the 3XD. We came out with the premise of maybe fishing them with a stop-and-go technique down deeper on the edge of the weeds. We saw the weeds, or we saw the bait fish on top, them busting. Hey, man, throw these out. If they want to eat it on top, we'll just keep doing what we're doing. But I mean, sometimes you just gotta alternate what you're doing, and you know, look what the fish is giving you, actually. If they want to eat it on top, hey, we'll give it to them on top. But that little bait with that fat profile, like a big shad, bright obnoxious colors, that's what's making these crappies bite. And it's gonna give us a good meal tonight.
Oh yeah.
Hey? Can't beat that, man.
Shows the versatility of the bait too, though.
Love it.
Another wake behind my lure. I wonder what that is.
Oh my God, sorry.
Hey, not a problem, I'm an athlete.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake. I was using the chartreuse with a lime back and the pink belly and just killer little bait, little red eyes, black spot. You know, some people say that black spot, the fish can focus in on it for attacking. Maybe that's the reason that they hit it sometimes at the side. But what they did do is eat it. Sebastian had on the pink with a little bit of black and stuff like that. And he got a few fish on that. But as soon as he upgraded his color choice to the chartreuse with the black spot, he got some big fish. We actually got the net to land. Come on, crappies.
There we go.
You got them?
I got a nice one, I think, too. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Look how much water is moving, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's sick.
Wow. I seen the wake coming towards the bait.
Wow.
Look at the size of these, yeah, man. Oh.
Let's see.
Whoa.
Wow.
Come on, Carl.
Oh,
can't
man.
Get better than that, buddy.
That's awesome.
This is amazing. And I seen the wake come up to the lure. Oh!
I watched him eat it, dude.
Yeah, go on the, yeah, right there, Carl.
Whoa, hold on, big slab.
Oh, buddy.
I watched this crappie eat it, dude.
That's a tank, dude.
I watched you come up. You know what? He didn't break the surface. I twitched it. It was going up, and he just went, like you said, sideways.
Oh,
wow, man.
Look at that tank. Dude, that's awesome.
Seriously?
Buddy.
Wake up, crappie.
Look at that. There. That's what it equals.
Wow, man. Look at those things. Little plates. Beautiful crappies, man. You ask me why I fish for crappie. We're addicted to crappie. It's sick. You know what I mean? It's like a disease. But you know what? It's not an addiction if you don't want to stop. You know, seriously. Yeah. You know what I mean? And the only fix I get is by coming out. Which way can I catch them today? There must be a new way to do it. Boy, I just feel like that. You stole it. I tell you, man, it makes you feel like a kid again. Go crappie fishing. You get addicted, you'll never stop.
Oh, it hasn't popped up. Maybe he's already got it. Yeah, I think he does. No, he came off.
Jeez. Look at that. Oh,
dude.
Wow, I saw it again.
Awesome, buddy.
I saw the shadow coming up.
Oh,
wow.
Man. That's a tank, dude.
Wow. Something else, man. Whoa, easy crappie. We don't want to catch me now, do we? Wow. But that's another. We'll let him go. We'll keep getting bigger ones each. Think about it. We're getting picky now, man. Getting picky. Ready? Go on. Simple, simple system, man. Casting the bait, watching the bait, get eaten. Wow.
Look at this. Boom.
Wow.
Right beside the boat. Sight fishing? Yeah, let's do that too.
Look at the water splashing, eh?
Oh, man. These are all nice fish. Look at that. That is just beautiful. Wow.
Oh, I'd say. Oh, this way, eh?
Watch this. Mine came out of the water. So watch your baits. You'll see.
Oh. You had a bite already.
Yeah.
But again, it's those bigger ones, eh?
Wow!
Oh my God. Really, man. This is just a shaker. Get those pliers. Let me just grab those. Can you pass those to me? Thanks. Dude, we watched him come up with about four of his friends, but he's just a shaker. One of the keys of catching these fish this morning was looking what the conditions offer. You know, we had the preconceived notions that we're going to use the 3XD and dive it down a little bit deeper and stuff, and that was a great game plan because we know those weeds are coming up on the edge of spawning bays and stuff. But we watched the minnows bust first thing in the morning, a little bit of activity, give what the lake gives you. So pay attention and alter your techniques, your cadence and stuff, because sometimes the fish will show you what they want, and today they wanted it on top, sitting there still before they ate it.
Oh, wow. Buddy, you do.
Look at this thing fight. Look.
Look at the mouth on him.
Yeah, man. Look at this scrap. Tell me that's not fun, man. Wow. Dude, you want a meal? Oh, actually, you know what? I got this one illegally. Look, he's not in the mouth. He has to go back. Oh.
Carl, mine just came out.
Look. On the side. That's how crazy they are. I gotta let fish like that go.
Yeah.
He was illegally caught, unintentionally. There's a female too. Look at her. Ready? Go on, girl. This is what happens. Watch this. See the bait right there? I'll show you. It sits on the surface like that. We make a little twitch. That's it. Little twitch. And it sits. That's it. Twitching it. See how it just moves? Twitch. They see that thing and they just slam it. Wow. Oh, I saw you! Holy God, dude! Wow! Holy God, man! What a... Another one! Holy...
Oh! That's
you
a
see
giant,
how big
dude.
That was?
That's a giant. Look at that.
Oh, my God, man. I just finished saying that there's giants in here. Did you see how big he was sideways?
Yeah. Talk about exciting.
Oh! It's hard to beat it, man. Can't beat this.
It's amazing. We're using this like a wake bait.
Yeah.
That's it.
Waking crappie. Wake up.
Oh, that's a tank. Hands down,
so.
Tank.
Yeah. I saw the water moving.
Dude, that's what we're looking for. Right there. Oh, buddy. Right there, Carl.
Awesome.
This is huge. Hit like a bass.
Oh, wow. That's big crappie, man.
Yeah. Oh, man. It doesn't get better than this.
Oh.
He came up just like a smallie. Oh, man. Did he ever nail that? Think you wanted to eat that? What a beautiful fish. Look at that.
Wow.
This is just amazing. That's bigger than a plate. That's a pan.
Wow, what an exciting way to catch crappies, man. Waking the 3XD on the surface. Like, we came out with our first attempt was to cast these 3XD, crank them down, let them sit by the weeds, and then slowly come up. We didn't even have to. Casted it, twitched it once or twice, and those bigger ones, right out of the water. If you didn't get a bite, you twitch it a little bit, you'd watch, and they come up, boom. Someone just actually took it and swam with it. So another piece of the puzzle of catching big slab crappie with the 3XD waking right below the surface, right here on the Xtreme Crappie Angler. Thanks for watching. We're gonna see you next time with another deadly technique on how to catch big, fat, super slabs.
The Xtreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, the leader in crappie. Sportsman Protein Shake, power your obsession. Strike King Lure Company, over 50 years of domination. Power Pole, shallow water anchor. Gamma Fishing Line, crappie magnet, sore lip them all. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.